Hello, my dear students. Now we are into the last unit. Myself, Professor Ankita Naik, and we are into the last unit of your soft skill development and etiquettes. Okay, so in this particular unit, we are going to learn the preparing of your bio data, your CV, social and soft skill development, group discussion, personal interview, video and teleconferencing, presentation skills, negotiation skill, aesthetic skills, etiquettes, different types of etiquettes, quitting techniques, exit interview. So all these things we are going to learn into this particular kind of unit. Okay, so this is probably the last unit of your this subject. Okay, here you will be getting lot more examples, like how you yourself will be preparing for the corporate world. So we are going to discuss a lot of things over here. So let's start with our first topic, like preparing the bio data and a CV. So let's first understand what the meaning of them. The word resume, curriculum, then bio data used many of the times in today's world, but we should first understand the meaning of it. First of all, we will learn what is resume. Resume is a French word which is means summary. Summary of your entire thing, what you have done for your particular kind of job. Okay, a simple resume may not longer than 2 or 3 pages size of A4 size. Like first and utmost question, how your resume should look like, because your resume is portraying yourself, how as a person you are and what you are going to do. So it is not more than 2 to 3 pages, the basic rule. Okay, resume gives importance to the academics, professional qualifications, voluntary experiences, achievements and accomplishments. So all these details should be there. There are generally two types of resume. One is your reserve resume, and next one is your functional resume. Reserve resume, where the work experience is sorted on basis of the number of years served in the organization. So here you can call it as a professional resume, and one is your fresh resume as a fresher. Okay, and functional resume, where the main focus is given on the skill set required for the particular kind of job or process. So many of the times what you have to do, like you must be applying for the different company, different jobs, but same department. So you have to change accordingly. You have to change according to the needs and wants of the particular kind of company. Resume is more applicable for the middle or senior level job, where the experience and skill set get more preference in the academic qualifications. As I said, har job ki category hoti hai, which is fresher ke liye hota hai, someone is for experience and someone is for the top management. So resume is very important and more applicable for the middle level and senior level jobs, where your experience plays very important role. Then your skill set gets more preferences on the academic qualifications. Then it comes to your CV, that is your curriculum value. Okay, CV means a course of life, like what you have done into your particular kind of life. The curriculum wide is more specifically focused on academic achievements than your work, your experience, your behavior, your career objective, your educational qualification, academic details like what is your scores and everything. Then it comes to your technical skill set, your strength, weakness, opportunities and academic honors, awards. So this is very important for your particular kind of CV, that is your curriculum wide. Okay. The CV are no longer as a resume. It is very short, okay, as it emphasizes on competencies, so the details create a good impression about the individual to help to get the job. So this is for CV is majorly for you guys, all my dear students who will be applying or entering into the corporate world very soon in 1 or 2 years. Okay, the curriculum or a CV should always be accompanied by the cover letter. You all must be knowing about the cover letter, right? Cover letter is a basic information about yourself will be giving over here. Like, it should be about your what you are, how you're doing. It is some kind of summary, that is essay, which is about you, which should be attached to your CV. CV is preferred option for a fresh graduate, for all of you guys, people looking for the career change. Like I am into the marketing industry, I wanted to switch to the HR or finance department or any kind of branding department. So it is for them, for a fresh start, and those applying for the academic positions. Okay, there are certain jobs which is based, government jobs mostly, which is preferred on basis of your academics, like your education. So there your CV take place. Okay, next is comes to your biodata. What is your biodata? Biodata means a biological data or a biographic data. It is defined as one life and work experience. The main focus is on a personal attributes like your birth date, then your religion, gender, race, nationality, PAN, passport, Aadhaar card, your transfer certificates, temporary, your residence, your marital status, your hobby, height, weight, hair, skin, eye colors, and photos. So this is about your biodata, like how you look like. Okay, it can predict all the features, future behavior of from the biological experiences or a biological knowledge which company has about a particular kind of person. Biodata is generally used for a defense job, government job, where applying for a research projects or research guards. So here your biodata plays very important role. So we have learned the three types of your CVs, or three types of how you will prepare yourself. First of all, it is about your resume. Resume is more for your senior level management or middle level people, where your work experience, your skill set plays very important role. Next is come to your CV. CV is more about your for a fresh graduate, those who wanted to apply for a new job or a new career. So it is for them, or applying for the academic based job. CV is a short brief about yourself. At this particular phase, you have to look about the good impression how you will create. It will be about your academic details, your personal details, your skill set, strength, weakness, then your academic honors, your achievements will be mentioned into your CV. Okay, and next one is your biodata. Biodata means a biographical data. It is defined one's entire life. Okay, this is main focus on a personal attributes like your Aadhaar card, your PAN card, your photograph, your temporary address, where your marital status, then hobbies, height, weight, everything. So this is mostly for your defense job, like your police or military, where this takes very important role, where your physics matters more. Then your government jobs, where you have to take all these things into the consideration, or applying for the research groups. Okay, so now we will understand the basic element of the CV. To prepare any kind of CV or resume, what you things you need to consider. So all my dear students, all of you have to give lot of attention, because this is very 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 important topic for all of you. Like whatever you are studying today, it is going to end up to this only. Okay, so whether a potential employer look into a CV or resume, they look for the document that proves a particular individual has done this amount of thing, or ideal candidate which is suitable for their organization to invest their time and money. Essentially, it's a sales brochure. You are going to sell yourself to any kind of company. Or it should be having the various details. So now we are going to discuss about the what all the important factor for your CV. First of all, it is about your details. Okay, it include your name, address, phone number, then your email address. So many interested employees can contact a candidate very easily. Information such as nationality, age, driving license, status are optional. This is up to you, but this is your basic details should be there, like name, details, or your email ID or address. So anyone who like your CV will get in touch with you. Then personal statements. This objective that immediately capture the attention of the reader. The significant skills of the candidate must be linked to the job, like your personal statements, like you have done some course, you have done something very which is unique, so it can grab the attention of that particular person. Then it comes to your education. Present details of academic and professional qualifications in your CV needs to be mentioned, along with the grades which are achieved. Then about your work experience. The details of the previous work experience, name of the company, job title, your position, your designation, your salaries, roles, responsibilities, duties, what you have performed, everything should be mentioned into your CV. Extracurricular activities. Extracurricular activities is always very important aspects when you're joining a new job, because every organization needs a person who is very all-rounder kind of thing. Okay. In case of fresh graduate who do not have any work experience, they must mention all the skill like a communication skills. Like all of you, you are a fresher. What you will ask me the question like, what I should mention in my CV? It should be your communication skills, time management skills, your presentation skills, any important events which you must have attended during the time of your college time. Like every college they have their fest, so if you are into those managing teams, anything you have achieved during the time of your college events, so you have to mention everything over here. Then it comes to your hobbies and interests, and special hobbies and skills that have direct link to the job must be mentioned in the blog. Okay, so every time don't mention that I have my hobby which is dancing and singing. Okay, if you are applying for certain job, example if it is a marketing job, what you should do, you should always say my hobbies will be communicating with the people, interacting with the different people, socializing myself. So these are certain hobbies or interest which match to your job profile, you should always mention in your CV. Then it comes to your achievements, like what you have achieved, any specific things which you have received, like any scholarship, any kind of appreciation, any significant achievement in your career you can mention, like you have cleared MPSC, you have cleared UPSC, you have cleared the NET exam, you have cleared the, in schools we have the Homi Baba exams and your scholarships. So every achievement you have to mention over here. Then last part of your CV is your references. This can include the name of the your school teachers. I will be talking from student point of view over here. Okay, so it will be about your school teacher, principal, previous employee, family, friends, and their name, designation and address. This is a process where anytime employer can get in touch with them to understand about yourself. Like many of the campus recruitment, this happens. Like whichever candidate they select, they always do these things. Like getting in touch with their HODs or principals to understand the student nature. Okay, so this is a basic criteria how you can make the CV, which will be include. First of all, it is your details, which is about your name, address, where anybody can get in touch with you. Personal statement, then your education, then your work experience, extracurricular activities, hobbies and interests, achievements, and last one is your references. Okay. And before for references, you should always inform the reference person in advance, because and prior permission from them while giving the names of the references, because they should be aware that your name has been given to them. Okay. Now we will understand what things you will be remembered while making the CV. So these are certain tips for you. It should be easy to read and simple layout. There should not be so complicated kind of thing. It must be clear, concise, yes, very interesting to read. Avoid italicizing versions and regular fonts. Okay. Use bond paper with a watermark for make the CV. Avoid dark colors or printed papers for your CV. Use the same kind of paper for a resume and cover letter. Like it should be very same. Free from like any typographical errors which should be there, like any spelling mistakes. So this should not be there into your resume or a CV. The resume is normally accompanied by the cover letter. The cover letter is either sent in response to the achievement of the job, or it can be sent with your CV. Okay, this is the first opportunity that candidate get communicate with the prospective employer. So design your CV very carefully and remember these points while you are making your CV for any job application. And every CV, certain parts will be changed according to the needs of the particular kind of job.